Don't ever start a business if you have these three habits. Just a moment before we delve into this video, we're excited to announce to you that we have started a new, wonderful channel designed to give you unique inspirational videos. We call it Hunt TV, and you can join in the description box. Thank you. So, a few days ago, I was with one of my friends. He is an entrepreneur, just like me. And we were talking about some of our crazy decisions, comparing them with the decisions of most people around us. It is as though as we were both raised by the same parents. But that's far from it. We came from an entirely different culture and grew up in different parts of the country. So, if we weren't trained by the same parents or grew up in the same culture, why do we have almost identical habits about money? Here's the thing. Entrepreneurship is like a religion. It doesn't matter where entrepreneurs grow up or how different their early life is, some certain traits and habits go with being an entrepreneur, just as certain belief systems go with being a Christian or a Muslim. And don't get me wrong here, I don't mean to say that entrepreneurs are born. Just like you can be converted into any religion at any age, you can be converted to entrepreneurship. And here are the three habits you'll never have as an entrepreneur. Short-sightedness. One day, one of my employees asked me, "Sir, why don't you have a car?" This was a reasonable question, since I seem to have more money than most people who own cars around me. But because I'm an entrepreneur, I try to look at things from the long-term perspective. Which is better for me, to own a car now or to employ one or two more people for my company? If I own a car now, I'll look rich. But if I employ one or two more people for my business now, I'll become richer this time next year. This video isn't made to discourage you from owning a car. It's just an example of how most people are short-sighted in their thinking. If you want to be an entrepreneur, you must think like a cocoa farmer and not like a corn farmer. The difference between the two is that if you plant corn, you'll harvest it in the next 90 days. But if you plant cocoa, you'll have to wait for a few years. However, a cocoa farmer has his streaks of making his money year after year for many years to come, while a corn farmer loses all his corn after a single harvest. If all you see is today, you're not made for entrepreneurship. If all the games you can play are the ones that reward you in a short time, you can never be an entrepreneur. Uber started in the year 2009, and till today, that company is not profitable. Google bought YouTube on 13th November 2006. Until the last time I knew, Google hasn't made money from YouTube. These are mighty companies, and it's easier to think it's because they are big, but that's not so. Most entrepreneurs sacrifice 5 to 10 years before they become successful. If you want to eat your cake now, you need a job, not a business. Excuse making. In the Christian religion, for example, you're not expected to lie or have sex when you're not married. You can complain that these laws are too difficult to obey. Well, obey them anyway. In entrepreneurship religion, we don't make excuses. Yes, just as you could complain that lying is natural and shouldn't be a sin, so many people make excuses because it's easy and reasonable. To be an entrepreneur is to be an actor. You don't make excuses, even when it's reasonable to do so. I don't have money. The economy is bad, I have kids, my parents don't help me, and the government is bad. While all these could sound like legitimate reasons not to start a business, our religion as an entrepreneur doesn't allow them. The creed of entrepreneurship is get out and get things done, no matter how difficult it may be. The good news is that excuse making is not what you were born with. It's a habit and can be changed. How to stop making excuses is by starting to reprogram your mind. Stop seeing why it's not your fault. Start seeing why you are to be blamed. Take full responsibility for your life, and you'll start blaming the person you see in the mirror. Time monitoring. I just got a report from my phone that I spent 49 hours on my mobile phone screen last week. If I don't get this kind of report, there's no way I'll ever believe that I spent half of such time on my phone. The truth is, our mobile phone has become our closest companion. And if care is not taken, we'll waste our life by simply enjoying what the internet offers. I don't mean to say that spending a ridiculous amount on the phone is a crime. I mean, you have to know what you do with such hours before, because if you don't, you'll end your life in poverty. For example, my entire business relies on the internet, and my mobile phone is the easiest instrument to check and track anything. I also consume many educational videos here on YouTube. And that's not to say I don't wander from time to time, but I try to use my time on the internet to favor my bank account. Again, our religion as entrepreneurs doesn't allow time wasters. That's because there are a million things to do before you can successfully build a company from scratch. You can't be busy consuming social media for entertainment and you'll want to be a member of our religion. You can't be busy gossiping about every little thing and want to be a part of our religion. Entrepreneurship requires crazy focus and extreme determination, which most people don't have. Time, that's the only asset you can ever have that can never be bought or regained. Waste it, and you won't be able to build anything worthwhile. Live for tomorrow. Stop making excuses. Stop wasting time. If you like this video, you might like our new motivational channel. We call it Hunt TV. And you can join the Hunt TV in the description box. We love you.